morning or good afternoon, depending on where you're at. Welcome to our latest Give Fitness live workout. My name's Mailee and I have Anne assisting me today. We're really excited about doing this live class for you guys, and it will be recorded so you can watch it at a later date. Remember to listen to your bodies before you listen to me. We don't want anybody getting any injuries, so if anything hurts, just don't do it or back off on the pose. You should feel yoga in your muscles, not your joints. So once again, you know your bodies better than we do, so listen to your bodies before you listen to me. Today we're gonna start on our backs. So we're just gonna come down onto our backs. Go ahead and hug those knees in. You can rock side to side. Maybe place the hands on the knees, just do a few circles. Just giving that lower back and back body a little massage. Just beginning to slow down. When you're ready, we'll let the feet settle down to the mat with the knees bent. Feet are about hip distance apart. We're gonna bring one hand to the heart, one hand to the belly, and gently close the eyes here. Now I'm gonna sit up so you can hear me a little better. But go ahead, stay down on your mat. One hand on the heart, one hand on the belly. With the eyes closed, just beginning to bring your attention to your breath. Just noticing where your breath is at. Beginning to quiet that very busy mind that's been busy reacting to so many things going on around us lately. So trying to quiet that mind, bring your attention to the breath. Just noticing the rise and fall of your breath, and as you inhale, feeling the chest press into your hand, the belly rises, the rib cage expands. And as you exhale, everything softens and you just melt into your mat. We're going to try to focus on the breath for the next hour, trying to let those busy thoughts just float away, exhale them away, let them go, and instead we'll focus on our movement and our breath. So as you inhale, inhale into the back of the throat, inhaling into the back body, nice deep inhales as if you could inhale all the way into your toes and your fingertips. Ready, you can begin to gently blink the eyes open. Go ahead, bring the knees back to your chest, do a few more circles, rock side to side, whatever feels best for you this morning. When you're ready, either pressing yourself up or maybe taking three rocks if you're feeling a little playful, we inhale as we rock up. Exhale back, inhale up, exhale back, and go ahead, come to a comfortable cross-legged seated position. Really ground down through your sit bones, sit up nice and tall. We'll begin to warm up the neck here just a little bit, so we're just gonna let the head hang nice and heavy, rocking it from one shoulder to the other. If you have a really tight neck, this is a great place to hang out. Maybe just going back and forth here. But as your neck begins to warm up, you can begin to rainbow across the top, making small circles, taking it nice and slow. Noticing if there's any spots that need a little extra attention. You can spend a little extra time in those spots if you need to. Next time your chin comes to your chest, we'll pause. Go ahead, switch directions, starting out slow and small. As the neck warms up, you can make those circles a little bit bigger, a little bit faster. Time your chin comes to your chest, we'll pause again. Gently let that chin float up back to center. And we're going to go through a few intentions for our class today. These are totally optional, but if it's something you'd like to do today, you can do that with us. So we're just going to inhale the arms up, palms come together at the top, exhale it down. I am healthy. Inhale the arms up, exhale it down. I am happy. Inhale up, exhale down. I am safe. We'll send it out to the world. May all people be healthy. Exhale down. May all people be happy. One more. Inhale up. May all people be safe. Anytime your hands come together in practice today, you can use any of those intentions, or just keep them in mind or come back to them when your mind tends to come to other thoughts. Next, we're going to inhale the arms up. Exhale, lean to your right. Really ground down with that opposite hip, that left hip. Reach with your fingertips, press the hip away. Inhale up. Exhale, opposite side. Inhale up. Exhale as we twist to our right. Left hand comes to the knee, opposite hands for support behind the hip. Inhale, center. Exhale, twist left. Inhale the arms up. We're going to take the hands behind you, interlace the fingers, open up the shoulders back behind you. I'm going to turn around just so you can see this. We're going to take the hands over to that left hip. Just hook it on that left hip, let the left ear drop to that left shoulder. Switch inside, take the hands over, hook them on the hip, right ear to right shoulder. Take the arms nice and wide. We'll take right arm over left. Give yourself a hug, a much needed hug. We'll shrug the shoulders up and down, up and down. Look right, look left. One more time, right and left. And then fold the head over, right, left, right, left. Coming back to center. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, lean to your right. Inhale, center. Exhale, left. Inhale, twisting to your right. Inhale, center. Exhale, twist left. Inhale, center. Exhale the arms behind you, interlace the fingers once again. Open up the shoulders, squeeze the shoulder blades back behind you. Take the chest and the heart forward. Release. We'll take the fists over to that right hip, right ear to right hip, or right ear to right shoulder. And switch sides. And release. Take those arms nice and wide again. Left over right this time, or opposite to what you did before. Give yourself a hug. We'll do a couple of those shoulder shrugs. One, two. And then look right and left again. And then fold the head right and left. Take the arms nice and wide one more time. This time we'll go right over left. We're going to intertwine the arms. See if you can maybe bring the palms together or just bring it to the wrist if you can hook it there. Eagle arms. We're going to try to press the elbows away and a little bit up to get a stretch through the upper back, shoulders, traps. Breathe into the back body. Just take a few breaths here. And then we're going to take a small fold. Chin comes to your chest, rounding through the back, and then inhale up. Do two more rounds just like that. Exhaling it down. Inhale up. Do one more. Gently release the arms, take them nice and wide. Left over right, or opposite to what you did before. Wrap the hands. If that's too much, you can simply wrap, take the hands to the shoulder, crossing the arms. Once again, press the elbows away with just a little bit of lift. Breathe into the back body and shoulders. Taking a few deep breaths here. Take our fold, rounding through the back, exhale it down, inhale up, exhale down, inhale up, one more round. Gently release, we'll take the palms of the hands to the thighs. Inhale the shoulders all the way up into the ears. Nice deep inhale, and with an exhale, let them drop. Do two more like that. Inhale up. Exhale through the mouth. And then flip the hands for this last one. Palms facing up. Inhale the shoulders up. And exhale. Nice. Next, we're going to come up to our coming up to the knees, tucking the toes underneath. Now this can be really intense on the toes, so a couple options is taking the weight off the toes or coming off the toes. But while we're doing that, we're just going to bring the arms up, begin to shake out the wrists. Starting out slow, and then a little bit faster. Now go ahead and shake them nice and fast. Remember, if your toes are screaming at you, go ahead, give them a break, listen to your body, and then we'll switch it up and going back and forth, starting out slow, and a little faster. We're going to alternate. So we're going to, one's going to go sideways and one's going to go forward. We're going to smile and give it a try. Nobody's watching. I had to practice this one in the mirror at home a few times to get it. It makes you laugh too, so it's okay. Be playful. We're not serious here. And switch. If you're feeling challenged, start out with one and then try to add the other. This is called cross-patterning. It's good for our brains as well as our wrists. And switch. I didn't tell Anne about this one, so she's completely new to it. And one more switch. And release. Shake those arms out. Come off those toes. You can give them a little pat on the mat to help release the tops of the feet. If and only if it feels okay on the knees, you can sit back on the feet. Stretching out the tops of the feet, just do a few circles with the knees. Nice and gentle. Do a few in one direction and switch. And release. Next, we're going to come to our tabletop position. We'll do a few cat-cows. Inhaling as we roll up. Exhale, tuck the hips, roll through the spine, head comes last. Continue to move with your breath, inhaling as you come up, exhaling it down. Slight pause at the top and bottom of the pose. Each time the movement begins in the hips, roll through the spine, head comes last. Couple more rounds. Make it feel good for your body. One more round, and we'll meet back at flat back. Gonna make our way into our happy puppy. So we walk those hands out about as far as you can reach them. You want the hips to stay directly above the knees. Nice straight line there. Exhale the head, the forehead, the chest down to the mat. Use a pillow here or a block if you need a little support. Those wanting to take it a little deeper can play.
play with coming up to their chin. Everybody lets the heart sink down towards the mat. Breathe into the upper back and shoulders. When you're ready, we'll slide the hips back for our first child's pose, taking the hips back, arms extended, palms facing down. For those of you that this is hard on the knees, you can always place a pillow underneath you for a little bit of support, or a block if you have one. You can rock the hips side to side here, rock the forehead side to side. Thinking about softening and releasing. Coming back to that nice, even breath we started out with. Go ahead and walk the hands over to the right side of the mat. Take left hand on top of right. Let that left hip sink to the side. Walking the hands over to the opposite side. Right hand on top of left. Let that right hip sink to the side. Nice deep breathing into that right rib cage. Gently release. Come back to center. Take a few breaths here. Remembering child's pose is a pose you can come back to at any time during class. If you need to center yourself or just come back to your breath, you're welcome to come back here at any time. You're in charge of your practice. Modify to make it feel good for you. When you're ready, we'll inhale it back up to tabletop. Nice flat back here. Knees are about hip distance apart, directly under the hips. Hands are directly underneath the shoulders. We're gonna step just that right foot out to the side, toes facing towards the front of the room. We're gonna begin to make hip circles. As we make those hip circles, we're gonna bend the knee as we come around, making the circles as big as you can. You're really trying to explore that hip socket, inviting some movement into it, waking it up a bit. Go ahead, switch directions. We'll do one more round. Coming back to straight leg. We're gonna lift that foot up off the mat. Tap it down, one, two, three, two more, four, five, release. We're gonna swing that leg all the way behind us, take it to the other side of your leg, tap that toe on the mat, and then gaze over that shoulder at that foot. Take a few breaths here. We're gonna do five taps, so we're gonna swing that leg back around, tap it on the mat next to you, tap, five, swing it back, look over the shoulder, four, three more, three, two, one, and release, step it back in. Switching sides, we'll step that left leg out. Beginning with your hip circles, just pick a direction. Making nice big circles. Just taking notice if one side's maybe a little different than the other. Many of us are very one-sided, so if you have one side that's a little more challenged, go ahead and spend a little extra time on that side. switch directions. One more round. Coming back to straight leg. We'll do our five taps on this side. Inhale the leg up. Tap. Tap. Three more. Three. Two. One. Release. We'll swing that leg back behind you. Take a gaze over that shoulder at your back foot. Take a few breaths here. And then we'll swing it back around. Five times. Five. Look over the shoulder. Four. Three. Two. One. Release. Take a few cat-cows here to release. Again, we'll come back to flat back. We'll start on that first side again. Step that right foot out, toes facing the front of the room. We're going to walk the hands back to sit back on the foot, maybe coming down to forearms or blocks or a pillow. If you're not feeling the stretch on the inside of the leg here, you can walk those toes out just a little bit so you find the stretch. Breathe into it. Focus your breath where you're feeling the stretch. Next, we're going to walk the hands out as far as you can reach them towards that right foot. Take a few breaths here. And release. Gently press yourself back up to tabletop. Then we'll walk the hands back towards us. We're going to come up and prepare for our gate pose. We'll take the right hand on that right hip. Inhale the opposite arm up nice and tall. Reach nice and tall. We're going to take three rounds to exhale it over. Exhale over. Inhale up. Exhale over. Inhale up. And we'll hold this time. You can take your gaze to the ceiling or the inner elbow. Breathe into that left side body. Gently release. We're going to plant the hand directly under the shoulder, but in line with your knee. So nice straight line between your hand, knee, and foot. Once you're there, stack the shoulders. Optional, maybe lifting that foot. Once you lift the foot, or if you have it on the mat, either way, everybody takes the arm up overhead, reach nice and long, point the toes for a nice extension. If you're working on balance, you're just going to stay right here. Want a little bit more of a challenge, we're going to exhale knee to elbow, inhale up, exhale down, inhale up, three more, three, two, one, and we'll hold, restack those shoulders, release the foot, we're going to swing it all the way back over, take it all the way back. Take a few breaths and release. Take the hands back down to the mat. Step that leg in. We'll switch sides. Step the left leg out. Begin to walk the hands back, maybe walking that foot out so you find a good stretch on the inner groin or inner leg there. Coming down to blocks, forearms, maybe pillows if you have them. You can stack the fists and take forehead to fists. Notice if your mind tends to wander. Go ahead, bring it back to some of our intentions or bring it back to your breath. We'll go ahead and walk those hands out, walk them all the way over to the left towards that foot. reach towards that foot.
Gently release, walk the hands back out, press it up, it's back to tabletop. We'll walk the hands back to come up to our gate pose on this side. This time, left hand to left hip, right hand nice and tall, reach up, something's just out of your reach, and then we'll exhale it over. Inhale up, exhale over, inhale up, and we'll hold this time. Breathe. Nice deep breathing into that right rib cage. And release. Plant the hand directly underneath your shoulder, in line with the knee. Stack the shoulders. Once again, it's optional. Maybe lift that leg. Everybody takes the arm overhead, reach nice and long, point the toes, reach with the hand. And then we'll exhale it down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Three. Two. One. And hold. Restack the shoulders. Release the foot. Press it up and take it all the way back over. Release. Plant the hands, step that leg back in. We'll take a widening child's pose, so big toes come together, knees nice and wide, take the hips back. Rock the forehead side to side. Just noticing how this child pose feels. When you have the knees apart, you feel it a little bit more in the hips. When we have the knees together, you feel it a little bit more in the lower back. So just noticing what works best for you. On the inhaling back to tabletop. Taking a few cat-cows here, just rolling through the spine a few times. Downward dog, so tuck the toes, plant the hands, press the hips up, be playful with it, walk it out a bit, alternating raising heels up and down, twisting left and right, maybe bending the knees, just take a few moments, stretch it out. When you're ready, begin to find stillness. Spread those fingers nice and wide, gazing at the feet or maybe the knees, pressing those heels down, but it's okay to have a slight bend in the knees, but continue to press the heels down. The shoulders externally rotate to engage those shoulder blades, arms hug in towards the ears, and breathe. We'll bend just the right knee. Take it to the center line, really sink into that left heel. And switch, bend that left knee, take it to the center line, sink into that right heel. Release, coming all the way up to tippy toes. Exhale it down. Inhale up to tippy toes. Exhale it down and hold. Stepping the left foot to the center line, we'll inhale the right leg up. Bending at the knee, opening that hip, continue to press into the hands. Take a few breaths here. Re-straighten that leg, three-legged dog. Nice, slow, controlled movement. Exhaling knee to right elbow. It's okay if it doesn't touch. Inhale up. Exhale, knee to chest. Inhale up. Opposite elbow. Inhale up. We'll be
stepping into our warrior one, hug the knee into the chest before planting the foot between the hands. If it doesn't get there, wiggle into place. Back foot, come to a 45. Inhale those arms up. Taking a moment here, check your alignment. You should be able to see your toes. Knees tracking over about the middle toe, trying to straighten that back leg. Swivel the torso towards the front of the room. Once again, if you're working on balance, you're going to stay right here. Otherwise, we're going to take a nice deep inhale. And on the exhale, we're going to hot out. Inhale up, exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down. Two more. And hold. Release the hands, either side of front foot. Swivel that back toe, step it back to down dog. Inhale that left leg up, bending at the knee, open up that hip. Straighten that leg. Nice controlled movement on this side. Exhale, knee to left elbow. Inhale, get up. Exhale, chest. Inhale up. Opposite elbow. Inhale up. Hug that knee in the chest before planting the foot. Back foot comes to 45. Inhale it up. You want that front heel to line up with your back arch. That's what's going to give you balance. The wider your stance, the better. Swivel that torso towards the front of the room. Try to stack that knee over the ankle. Nice deep inhale here. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, and we'll hold. Release the hands, either side of front foot, swivel back toe, step it back to downward dog, take a few breaths here, walk it out again. Come to stillness. Bend the knees. Look between the hands. Step or hop feet, top of the mat. We'll inhale halfway up. Exhale it back down. Slight bend in the knees as we roll it up. Arms come up about halfway. Palms are going to come together at the top. Exhale to your heart center. We're going to come into a little bit of flow here. So starting at the tops of your mats. I'm going to show you two ways for coming down depending on your lower back needs. If you have a sensitive lower back, we're going to touch the back of the heart, touch the front of the heart, and roll it down. And when you come up, you'll slight bend the knees and roll it back up. Palms come together to the top. Exhale to your heart center. For those of you that would like a little bit more out of your workout and have stronger lower backs, we'll bring the palms together to the top, swan the arms out, and take your dive down. Slight bend in the knees. Inhale it up. Palms come to the top. Exhale to your heart center. So your choice, whichever you choose to go down, is your choice. And we'll begin inhaling. Touch the back of the heart. Touch the front of the heart. Rolling it down or flat back, your choice. Inhale halfway up. Exhale down. We're going to step the right knee back. Release the knee, release the toes, inhale the arms up. You can use a pillow or a blanket underneath the knee if you need it. And then release the hands, either side of front foot. Tuck the back toes, we're gonna step it back to plank. In plank, remember you have knees available if you need them. We're gonna lower knees, chest, chin, low cobra. Tuck the toes or roll over the toes, downward dog. Inhale the right leg up, stepping into our low lunge on this side, plant the foot, release the back knees, release the back toes, inhale up. Exhale it down, hands either side or front foot, tuck the back toe, we're going to step it forward. Inhale halfway up, hands on shins, nice flat back, exhale back down. Slight bend in the knees as we roll it up. Palms coming together to the top, exhale to your heart center. Continue inhaling, touch the back of the heart. Exhale, touch the front of the heart, roll it down. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale down, we'll step the left leg back this time. Inhale, the arms up. Exhale it down. Hands either side of front foot, tuck back toes, step it back to plank. Once again, lower, knees, chest, chin, look over. Exhale down, tuck the toes, downward dog. Inhale that left leg up. Step into your low lunge on this side. Release the knee, release the toes, inhale up. Exhale down. Tuck the back toes, lift that leg, step it forward. Inhale halfway up. Exhale down. Inhale, roll it up. We'll keep moving. Inhale, touch the back of the heart. Exhale, touch the front of the heart, roll it down. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale down, step that right leg back. Inhale it up. Exhale down. Step it back to plank. Maybe adding a chaturanga here, lowering halfway down to an upward dog or low cobra. Listen to your lower back needs. Tuck the toes, downward dog. Inhale that right leg up. Low lunge on this side. Inhale, hands up. Exhale it down. Tuck that back toe. Step it forward. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale it down. Inhale, roll it up. Exhale, heart center. Inhale. Touch the back of the heart. Exhale, touch the front of the heart. Roll it down. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale down. Step the left leg back. Inhale up. Exhale down. Tuck that back toe. Step back to plank. Your choice how you lower. Cobra or upward dog. Knee and downward dog. Inhale that left leg up. Step it forward. Release the knee. Inhale up. Exhale down. Tuck that toe. Step it forward. Inhale halfway up. Exhale down. Inhale. We'll be adding on this time. Inhale, touching the back of the heart. Exhale, touch the front of the heart. Roll it down. Inhale halfway up. Exhale down, step that right knee back. Inhale up. We're going to come into cactus arms here. We're going to bring the elbows forward, round through the back. One, and open it up. Two, elbows nice and wide. Three, and then round through the back. Four, one more. Five, and release. Hands either side of front foot, tuck back toe, lowering as you choose. Downward dog. Inhale the right leg up. Step it through. Release the knee, release the toes, inhale the arms up. Cactus those arms out. Five. Four. Three. Two, one, release, tuck that back toe, step it forward, inhale halfway up, exhale down, inhale roll it up, exhale down, one more, touching the back of the heart, exhale touch the front of the heart, roll it down, inhale halfway up, exhale down, we'll step the left leg back. Inhale, arms up. Cactus those arms. Five. Four. Three. Two. One. Release. Tuck the back toe. Step it back to plank. Lowering. Knee downward dog. Inhale that left leg up. Step into your low lunge. Release the knee, release the toes. Inhale, arms up. Cactus the arms. Five. knee back. Take a child's pose of your choice, knees together or apart. Take a few breaths here. Rock the hips side to side, rock the forehead side to side. When you're ready, plant the hands. Inhale through tabletop. Meet in downward dog, tuck the toes, hips come up. We're gonna inhale that right leg up. We're gonna step into our high lunge here. Plant that foot, really press into that back heel or foot. Maybe hands to knee, maybe press it all the way up. Feet are either side of a little skinny railroad track. Try to straighten that back leg. Once again, you should be able to see your toes here. We're gonna cactus those arms out, watching our balance. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release. Hands either side of front foot. Step it back, downward dog. Inhale that left leg. Stepping into our high lunge on this side, plant that foot. You want nice strong legs before pressing up. So get your base nice and strong before pressing it up. Straighten that back leg, find your balance. We'll cactus those arms out. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release. Hands either side of front foot, step it back to downward. Inhale that right leg up. Stepping into our high lunge again on this side. Find your base, press it up, find your balance. We're gonna twist to our right here. Right hand comes back behind you, left hand comes forward. Once you find your twist, flip the palms up, really reach in opposite directions and breathe. Release the arms, take them back up. Hands either side of front foot. Step it back, downward dog. Inhale that left leg up. High lunge on this side. Find your base. Nice, strong base before pressing up. Find your balance. Twisting to our left this time. Flip those palms up and reach and breathe. Release the hands either side of front foot. Step it back down. Left leg. Step into your high lunge on this side. Find your base. Press it up. Nice deep inhale here. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale up. Three more. Towards the ears, bring the palms of the hands together, take the palms above the head, walk the elbows away to get a little traction in the upper back, and breathe. Gently release. We're going to walk the hands out, come face down onto our mats. Stack the forearms, top of mats. Take a few breaths here. Your
you're having any lower back issues, this is a great place to hang out. Just breathing into the back body, focusing the breath, especially into that lower back. We're gonna press up to our Sphinx pose. Coming up to the forearms with the palms facing down. If this is too deep, you can just walk those elbows away. If you like them a little deeper, bring the elbows a little closer. You're gonna try to pull those shoulders down and away from the ears. Squeeze the shoulder blades back behind you like you could drag yourself forward on the mat. Breathe into the back body. Next time, we're going to press into our cobra, so taking the hands about shoulder width apart. Press up to your low cobra and hold. Once again, pull those shoulders down and away from the ears. Squeeze the shoulder blades back behind you. Breathe into the back body. Five breaths here. And release. Stack the forearms, form into forearms. Take a few breaths. Switch that up a little bit, so bring the hands for cobra again. This time we're going to inhale, right shoulder up, left shoulder up, right shoulder down, left shoulder down. Switching, left shoulder up, right shoulder up, left shoulder down, right shoulder down. Do two more rounds, switching back and forth. Ready to release, stack the forearms, forehead the forearms, take a few breaths. Once again, take the hands in line with your shoulders, but a little bit wider, so about as wide as your mat. We'll press up center, exhale, twist one side. Inhale, center, exhale, twist the other side. Take a few more rounds. One more set. And release, forehead to forearms. When you're ready, extend one arm out and just gently press yourself onto your back body. Find yourself back on the mat. Once you're there, hug those knees in, rock side to side, do a few more circles. Give that back body, lower back, a little massage. And we'll release the feet down to the mat. Folding right leg over left, flex that foot. And then we're gonna hug that left knee in, figure four. If you find that your shoulders are way off the mat, go ahead and hold behind the thigh instead of in front of the knee. Once you're there, hug that knee in. Use the elbow to press the knee away. If it feels good, you can rock side to side. Release the hands. We keep the same figure four shape. We're just going to roll over onto that left hip, stamp that foot on the floor. Take your gaze in the opposite direction of the legs. You can place the hand on the knee, but you don't want to pull just the weight of your hands enough. started, hug that knee in. Rock side to side if it feels good. Shape with the legs, roll over onto the right hip. Take your gaze in the opposite direction, maybe placing the hand on the knee. Arches of the feet, or maybe the ankles if you prefer. Flex the feet, pull the knees down and wide as if you could pull them down into your armpits. Tuck the chin just a little bit to get some extension through the spine and rock side to side. Give that back body a little massage. Gently release, slide the legs out onto the mat. Keep that left leg bent. We'll take a twist. So we're going to shift the hips over to the left a little bit and then let that left knee fold across the body. Airplane out the left arm. Gaze out over that arm. Try to keep that shoulder anchored on the mat. Breathing into your twist. Each inhale, you come out of your twist just a tiny bit. And on the exhale, relax back into that space you were creating. Never want to force your twist. Instead, we use our breath to ease into it. This feels a little too much on the lower back. You can bring that knee to a block or a pillow for support. Or just back out of it just a little bit. Ready? Remove the hand from the knee. Let that knee float back up. Slide that leg out. Switch sides. Before twisting, let the hips shift over to the right this time. Right knee folds across the body. Airplane out that right arm. Gaze out over the right arm. Nice deep breath. Shoulder blades down your back, arms are at your sides, palms facing up. We're going to lift just the right leg off the mat, just a little bit, maybe an inch off the mat, and then let it drop heavy onto the mat. Same thing with that left leg, lift the left leg off the mat just a little bit, and then when you're ready, let it fall nice and heavy. Both arms, palms facing up, come up off the mat, exhale, let them drop. Gently close the eyes here. Feel the support of the floor under your entire back body. Allow your body to feel heavy, allowing gravity to take over. Relaxing every part of your body, starting at the feet, relaxing the legs, the torso, relaxing the arms. Notice if you're holding tension in the neck, let the neck soften. Let the shoulders soften and melt down towards the mat. With the eyes closed, you can take the gaze down to your cheekbones, softening all the muscles in your face. If you have the tongue pressed against the roof, let it release. Gently part the lips, come to a nice, natural breath. And completely relax. Side to side. Take the hands above the head, interlace the fingers, stretch nice and long, point the toes. Gently pressing yourself up, coming to a comfortable cross-legged seated position. I'm just going to do a few rounds of sun salutations with just the arms, coming back to those intentions we said in the beginning of class. So we'll inhale the arms up, exhale them down. I am healthy. Healthy. May all people be happy. May all people be safe. Thank you so much for joining me in practice today. We thank you for joining us. Thank yourselves for showing up on the